Good morning. And welcome to our Thanksgiving Mass led by our fifth grade class. Today we're joined by Father Martisello as he says he celebrates the Eucharist. Please stand for the opening hymn.
Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Good morning, boys and girls, and I would like to wish you, if I don't see you after Mass, a happy Thanksgiving to all of you and your families. Today we come into the presence of Almighty God and to give thanks for all the gifts and favors and blessings that He has bestowed on us. And so we turn to Him as we acknowledge our sins to prepare these sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Amen. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. Stir up the will of your faithful, we pray, O Lord, that striving more eagerly to bring your divine work to fruitful completion, they may receive in greater measure the healing remedies your kindness bestows. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen.
The first reading is from the book of Daniel, chapter 2, verses 31 through 45. Daniel said to Nebuchadnezzar, "In your vision, O king, you saw a statue very large and exceedingly bright, terrifying in appearance, as it stood before you. The head of the statue was pure gold. Its chest and arms were silver. Its bellies and thighs bronze, the legs iron, its feet partly iron and partly tile."
While he looked at the statue, a stone which was honed from a mountain without a hand being put to it struck its iron and tile feet, breaking them into pieces. The iron, tile, bronze, silver, and gold all crumbled at once, fine as the tree from the threshing floor in summer, and the wind blew them away without leaving a trace. But the stone that struck the statue became a great mountain and filled the whole earth. This was the dream, the interpretation we shall also give in the king's presence. You, O king, are the king of kings. To you the God of heaven has given dominion and strength, power and glory. Men, wild beasts, and birds of the air, wherever they may dwell, he has handed over to you, making you a ruler over them all. You are the head of gold.
Another kingdom shall take your place, inferior to yours, then a third kingdom of bronze, which shall rule over the whole earth. There shall be a fourth kingdom, strong as iron. It shall break in pieces and subdue all these others, just as iron breaks in pieces and crushes everything else.
The feet and toes you saw, partly of potter's tile and partly of iron, mean that it shall be a divided kingdom, but yet have some of the hardness of iron. As you saw the iron mixed with the clay tile, and the toes partly iron and partly tile, the kingdom shall be partly strong and partly fragile. The iron mixed with the clay tile means that they shall seal their alliances by intermarriage, but they shall not stay united any more than iron mixed with the clay.
In the lifetime of those kings, the God of heaven will set up a kingdom that shall never be destroyed or delivered up to another people. Rather, it shall break in pieces all these kingdoms and put an end to them, and it shall stand forever.
And that is the meaning of the stone you saw hewn from the mountain without a hand being put to it, which broke into pieces the tile, iron, bronze, silver, and gold. The great God has revealed to the king what shall be in the future. This is exactly what you dreamed, and its meaning is sure.
The response is, give glory and eternal praise to him.
Give glory and eternal praise to him.
Bless you, Lord, all you works of the Lord. Praise and exalt him above all forever. Give glory and eternal praise to him.
Angels of the Lord, bless the Lord. Praise and exalt him above all forever. Give glory and eternal praise to him.
You heavens, bless the Lord, praise and exalt him above all forever. Give glory and eternal praise to him.
All you waters above the heavens, bless the Lord, praise and exalt him above all forever. Give glory and eternal praise to him.
All you hosts of the Lord, bless the Lord, praise and exalt him above all forever. Give glory and eternal praise to him.
For you in Christ Jesus. Hallelujah.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord.
While some people were speaking about how the temple was adorned with costly stones and votive offerings, Jesus said, "All that you see here, the days will come when there will be not, when there will not be left a stone upon another stone that will not be thrown down." Then they asked him, "Teacher, when will this happen? And what sign will there be when all these things are about to happen?" He answered, "See that you not be deceived, for many will come in my name, saying, 'I am he,' and the time has come. Do not follow them. When you hear of wars and insurrections, do not be terrified, for such things must happen first. But it will not immediately be the end." Then he said to them, "Nation will rise against nation, and kingdom against kingdom. There will be powerful earthquakes, famines, and plagues from place to place, and awesome sights and mighty signs will come from the sky." The Gospel of the Lord. Please be seated. Okay, so who's excited for Thanksgiving? Huh? All of us. And why are you excited for Thanksgiving? What's so special about Thanksgiving? What are some of the things that you do at Thanksgiving time? You eat until you can't eat anymore. Yes, that's certainly the case. Oftentimes. What else do we do? Yeah. Right, we remember the first Thanksgiving, the Pilgrims and the Native Americans, that's correct. I'm sorry? Yes, and we're thankful for what God has done. We give thanks to God. We count our blessings. Let's see. What else? Go ahead. And we eat turkey, yes. I'm sorry, one more time. Yes, we give thanks, absolutely. What else do we do? What do you do with your family? What happens? Is it just you at the dinner table? No, it's with you. Go ahead. Family comes together. You gather around the table, right? Everyone comes together. Perhaps that's the special part of Thanksgiving, is that we all come together. Go ahead. Yes, we all come together to give thanks for what God has given us. One more. Yes. To be thankful with family. Absolutely. And so, you gather as family, you come together around table, and you eat to give thanks for all the blessings in your life. And ultimately, to give thanks to Almighty God. And so, my brothers and sisters, what if I told you that every time you come to Mass, every time we come into this church and celebrate Holy Mass, that we actually celebrate another kind of Thanksgiving? I mean, we come together as a family of faith, right? Because we are a family of believers, and we come into God's house, who invites us to his Thanksgiving, and we come to his table. We come to his table, his altar, and we eat. We partake of the Holy Eucharist. The body and blood, soul and divinity of Jesus Christ. Jesus' true presence that God gives us through the hands of his priest. And so we come to this heavenly meal that God invites us to so that we can have eternal life in his only begotten Son, Jesus Christ. And by the way, boys and girls, do you know what the word Eucharist literally means? I'll give you a hint. It comes from the Greek. But what does Eucharist literally mean? Go ahead. Say it louder. Thanksgiving? That's correct. Did you really know that? Wow, that's very impressive. Eucharist literally means thanksgiving from the Greek language. And so every time we receive our blessed Lord, every time we receive Jesus in the most holy Eucharist, we give thanks to Almighty God for the gift of giving us his only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, so that anyone who receives him and believes in him may have eternal life and live forever in his kingdom. And so, my friends, boys and girls, there's a lot of blessings in our life. There are a lot of things to be thankful for. Is that correct? Right? What are some of those things that we are thankful for? Okay, go ahead. What are you thankful for? I'm sorry? Oh, being at church. Very good. Very good. What are you thankful for? I'm sorry? Your parents. Absolutely. Your family and friends. Going to this grade school. Did you hear that, teachers? Where's TJ? That's right. It is a great school. Go ahead. Louder. Food, right. Thankful for food that nourishes us, that sustains us. What else are you thankful for? I'm sorry? For the world. That's right, for being alive in the world. Go ahead. What are you thankful for? That's all right. That's all right. That's all right. You over there? Thankful for God? How about you? I'm sorry? Your house, where you live. Absolutely. So let's do a couple more. What are you thankful for? Your dog. For God. Absolutely. For life. Boys and girls, those are all great and beautiful examples of things that we are grateful and thankful for. The gift of your life, your existence, living in the world, having your family, your parents. But what about your gifts and talents? What about your different, maybe artistic abilities, your intellectual abilities, all these things that make you you. We're thankful for all these things. And so, boys and girls, let me just ask you something. When someone gives you something that you didn't earn on your own, or if someone gives you something that you don't really deserve, what's the proper response? So if I just was generous and I give all of you $20, a lot, huh? What would be the proper response? Yeah, thank you, right, right. Thank you. I hope you'd receive it, though, because I would give it generously. That's right, thank you. Thank you is the proper response, to give thanks, because we did nothing to deserve it. And so, my brothers and sisters, what did you do to deserve to be alive? Did you will yourself? Did you say, I'm going to exist in this world? No. Who gave you your life? Go ahead. God. God gave you your life? Who gave you your parents? Their parents, but ultimately, because he's the giver of every single human life. Okay? Who gives us food? Who is the creator of food? Mary? Close, not quite. God. God is the creator of food. God is the creator of everything. Boys and girls, my point is that all that we have and all that we are comes from Almighty God. Imagine that. Everything. Everything we have. Even the pets, the animals, the things that we like in the world. Everything ultimately comes from Him. And we did nothing to deserve it. We did absolutely nothing. God gives us this freely and graciously for us to receive and to accept. And in turn, like you said, it is proper and right to give God thanks. And so my brothers and sisters, we come to this church to give thanks to Almighty God. And that's what we do every time we come to Holy Mass, is that we celebrate God's gifts and favors and blessings, and we count them, and we come to Him, and we say, thank you. Thank you, God. Thank you, Jesus, for giving me all these good things in my life. Because I don't deserve them. I did not work for them. They're not of my doing. But you gave them to me because you love me. And so we give thanks to Almighty God. And so, my brothers and sisters, boys and girls, it is very important to have a grateful heart, isn't it? It's very important to count your blessings. So I encourage you, maybe perhaps today at school, maybe you can do a little 5-minute, 10-minute project in class, and just write down on a piece of paper all the things that you're thankful for. Write them all down. Everything you can think of. Write all those things down on a piece of paper. Count your blessings. And then after you've done that, say, thank you, God, for all these things. Because, boys and girls, this is the way to happiness. We all want to be happy, don't we? Right? But the way to true happiness is by being thankful, by being grateful for everything God has given us. And so part of showing that gratefulness, that thankfulness to Almighty God, is coming to Holy Mass, is coming before His presence. Imagine, God is present in this sanctuary. This is where we meet Him. This is where we come to say, thank you, Lord. Thank you for my life, for my parents, for my faith, for everything you have given me, for giving me a relationship with your only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, for redeeming me, for offering us the gift of eternal salvation. And so, boys and girls, let's make a deal, okay? Every day, when you wake up in the morning, begin your day with a grateful heart. Tell our Lord, thank you. When you wake up in the morning, tell God, thank you. Thank you for my life. Thank you for everything you have given me. And that's a beautiful prayer. And you will have a very happy day from that prayer. And then, when you're ready to go to bed, say thank you. Say thank you to Almighty God. Say thank you to our Lord Jesus Christ for all the things that He has blessed your day with and everything He has blessed your whole life with. Tell Him thank you. And you will be happy, and you will find peace in your life when you give your grateful heart to Almighty God. Does that sound like a deal, boys and girls? Can we say thank you? Because the more we say thank you, the more we will be happy, and the more we will be like Jesus Christ. Okay? And so I'm thankful for all of you for being here today, for letting me serve you as your priest. Thank you, boys and girls. Okay, let us stand. With faith, let us bring forth our prayers and petitions to the Lord.
Please respond. Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Blessed our priest, our Bishop Salvatore, our Pope Francis, and our teachers who work hard for us and do so much for us. Let us thank the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer.
Bless those who have been elected in office. Guide their decisions and laws so that all the people in the community may have opportunities to be safe, grow, and prosper. Let us thank the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer.
Send your spirit to all our people in the world today who do not have food or other basic needs. Bless the hands of all those who work to help the poor and sick. Let us thank the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Bless our parents and brothers and sisters and all of our family members and friends who are kind and forgiving, even if we've been unkind to them. Let us thank the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Bless our veterans and those in active service. Keep them safe from the violence of war. Give security and peace to their families in our world. Let us thank the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Bless our earth and its soil. Bless all those who grow and prepare the nourishing foods for us to enjoy. We are thankful for the delicious goodness of your creation. Let us thank the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We are so grateful for our Holy Cross School and all the school community who work and learn together. Continue to teach us about your ways of goodness and love. Let us thank the Lord. We pray for the repose of the soul of Vicky Harises, Miss E's mother. May her family find comfort and peace in her passage to you. Let us thank the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We unite these and all our poor prayers to those of the Immaculate Blessed Virgin Mary and speak them in the name of her Son, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated.
For the Lord.
pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Accept, O Lord, the sacred offerings which at your bidding we dedicate to your name, and in order that through these gifts we may become worthy of your love, grant us unfailing obedience to your commands, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For although you have no need of our praise, yet our thanksgiving is itself your gift, since our praises add nothing to your greatness, but profit us for salvation, through Christ our Lord. And so in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you, and with joy we proclaim. Of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
history of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, and Salvatore our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen, amen, amen.
Please stand. At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Thank you. Just a little reminder and instruction on how to receive Holy Communion, boys and girls. When you come forward, please receive Holy Communion by placing the host within your mouth, okay? And if you are not Catholic, or if you haven't received your first Holy Communion just yet, please refrain from receiving Holy Communion. So don't receive Holy Communion. Instead, you may come forward and receive a blessing from me with your arms crossed like this. Thank you. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Let us pray. We pray, Almighty God, that those to whom you give the joy of participating in divine mysteries may never be parted from you. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Before you go back to school, into the classroom, I would just like to wish you again a very happy Thanksgiving to you and your families. And remember, boys and girls, always give thanks to God. He has given you everything. Everything comes from Him. Everything belongs to Him. And so we give thanks to Almighty God. So in the morning when you wake up, what are you going to do? Thank you, Jesus, right? Say, thank you, Jesus. And before you go to bed at night, what are you going to say? Thank you, Jesus. Begin and end your day with a grateful heart, and you will have a happy life. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go in peace. Thanks be to God.
Thank you, Father. We have a song the fifth grade has prepared for everyone, and I'd also like to ask the choir to come up and join us.
Nice and loud, fifth grade. You ready?